Yo, what's up YouTube? We're back again. It's been a minute, but today I'm gonna be recording a leg day. I've been off of the gym. Well, I've been on the gym still, but not as consistently for probably, just not as like on top of my stuff as I usually would be. But I'm back on it now, trying to lock back in. A month and a half into a cut, and we're definitely getting there. Not quite yet, but we're getting there. I have 30 days until I go to Punta Cana for my senior year break. I just turned 18 2 months ago. And yeah, I'm ready just to lock in. I'm moving to Santa Cruz next year, so I'm hoping to post a lot when I move there. I'll be surfing a lot. I'm doing a road trip out there with a few of my buddies who live there right now. And we're gonna drive from Michigan all the way out there. And we're stopping at Colorado to see one of our buddies, go to Rocky Mountain backpacking trip. Then we're gonna drive through Utah to Bryce Canyon National Park. And then we're gonna go through Zion, drive straight from Zion through Las Vegas, just like check it out. And then we're gonna go San Diego, we have family friends there, and drive up. My sister's living in Long Beach, and then we're gonna go up to Santa Cruz where I'm gonna be living right out of high school. I mean, can't get much better than that, right? Back to today. I'm just making my cream of rice. I did one serving cream of rice, which is a fourth cup, 45 grams, and then I'm gonna mix in some frozen fruit, which I love adding because it just like melts into the, like this mixture. Yes. And it gives it the flavor because the actual cream of rice just tastes like, honestly just tastes like ass. So, I mix in this bag of frozen fruit. Whatever frozen fruit you choose. I like the berries more because like the juices from the berries come into the cream of rice and really give it that flavor that you're looking for. If you don't know what cream of rice is, that's what it is. 150 for a fourth a cup. It doesn't look like a lot when you pour it in. Once you like take it out of the microwave, yeah, one cup of water to the fourth, and it expands so significantly. I find that I started off with 90 seconds, mix it after the 90 seconds, and then keep adding 30 seconds and 30 seconds until it becomes super thick. And you'll definitely know when it's done. You gotta make sure you're stopping it pretty frequently so it's not overflowing over the sides and then making a mess in your microwave. It happened to me a bunch of times, so learn from my mistakes. So this is what it's looking like. Kind of just looks like rice pudding, but it's pretty thick. What I'm gonna do is throw this back in the scale, get our frozen fruit. All right, now the bag's open, we're gonna do, get the scale out. Just gonna get like a big handful. We're gonna do 50. Actually, we do a little more, we'll do like that much. 77.8, or 7, yep. Toss a little more in. 81.545. Okay. Now what we're gonna do, put that aside. And mix it in a little bit. Boom. Now we're gonna do is get some low calorie syrup. It's not the greatest for you, but tastes good. That's the main thing. You're gonna do, the serving size is 30 milliliters. You're gonna put it to milliliters. Boom. Just like you'd be surprised how much you can do. Pretty decent amount. I only do like a half side or serving. It's like 5 calories. And let's see how it tastes. Okay, so this whole meal here is 198 calories, roughly 200 calories. Not really any protein, it's just carbs. Perfect before the gym. I was just in Accutane. Why the skin's a little better since you guys last saw, but it means my like joints kind of got fucked, so I can't really do squats anymore. I know I got 315 squat and then I was kind of that, but really today. Might do some Smith squat, maybe even some squat, depending on how it feels. Back's getting a little bit better. It was mainly a lower back issue after Accutane. I mean, yeah, if you guys have acne, 100% recommend Accutane. I tried I tried everything you could think of. Yeah, I mean, I did every single pill, everything, and it worked. They all worked, doxycycline, all these different things. It worked, but the second I was off the pill, it was just instantly breaking out. And with Accutane, I think I did 6 months, and nothing. And I've been off it for probably 5 months. I finished in September, I think, so probably 5 months. And I'll get the occasional zit if I eat the whey protein, but nothing I can't manage. And I've just been doing plant-based stuff and mainly trying to get from Whole Foods. A great source of protein I've been using is 99.1 ground turkey. I think it's 120 calories, 28 grams of protein. I mean, you can't get much better than that. No protein bar can do that. So that, eggs, chicken, all the stuff, and then the occasional protein bar. I have a protein bar during my workouts to keep me feeling full and fueled. Because Jeff Nippard made a post about how the main factor for your workout is just feeling full versus feeling super hungry the whole workout. It's gonna affect your workout pretty significantly. Okay, so quickly before I go, I just finished that meal. I'm now gonna look in the protein bar drawer for some kind of plant-based one. Okay, so we're in the car. Shaker bottle. Just gonna quickly show you guys my pre-workout stack for today, which is the Woke AF. For my arm days and other days, I have this one. It's a non-stim, just pump-based workout. And then caged HCL creatine. I prefer this one. I feel like the monohydrate something about it just didn't sit well in my stomach. And this one's been working out really well for me in terms of just putting on muscle and recovery in general. Beep. Toss that in there. Beep. Go on, get out. It's stuck in the container. Come on. There we go. Okay. You know what? Throw in a little sprinkle for a good measure. Shake it up. I decided to go this far after all that. All right, I'm gonna bump some music. So I'll see you at the gym. Hey, trips that you plan for the next whole week. Been too long for a nigga so cheap. Being flex OD, sex OD, you got it, girl. Right now, about a mile. Just gonna see how fast I can go. Really, once the weather gets a little bit nicer, I'm gonna be running outside too. Right now, it's still pretty shitty outside, pretty grim. 2 miles done. For the second, the first mile, I had a 3 incline. 8 miles per hour, 7.5, and I got to 8 for the last 2 minutes. And then for the second mile, had the degree at 9%. And I was running 6 miles per hour basically the whole time. About to head in the sauna for a little bit. Get some more sweat going. Then we're gonna carry on the rest of our day. All right.
20 minutes still on a complete. Now I'm just gonna go home, shower. We're gonna go home, shower, and get a good meal in us. Tomorrow morning, just gonna do the exact same thing again, except for I have abs tomorrow and 2 miles again. And I'm just trying to really push that 2 miles as far as I can go. I'm just trying to get like 1 mile, 1.25, 1.5, 1.75, 2, 2.5, and so forth, just by the week. And the goal is eventually, well, not anytime soon, but within like my college years, to do a marathon, or at least a half marathon. Marathon. I'm pretty locked in. I'm just hoping it stays locked in and I'm not gonna just end up flopping like I did last time. But then again, it's all just discipline and comes down really to that and how bad do I really want it. In a couple of days, I think it's like 15-ish days, I'm going to the Dominican Republic for senior spring break. And I'm 18, so I'm sure you can imagine what's going to be happening. I'm going to try and just keep it, you know, a bit more low-key, but probably not. I'm trying to just really keep myself mentally just locked in versus distracting myself with just these small dopamine releases that just fuck with my whole week. So I'm really trying to cut down and lock into my goals. Especially now that I'm 18, I kind of feel like all this stuff I've been learning, now it's kind of just like, now it's coming into play. And I feel like I really need to just reassess my goals and if everything I'm doing is aimed towards that. When I move out to Santa Cruz, I want to start some sort of running club. And I'm going to be surfing probably daily or at least multiple times a week. So the cardiovascular will be pretty on. And I'm gonna stick to the gym. Always been a big gym, like big avid gym goer. In the summer, I sometimes lose it a little bit, but I still force myself to go for at least 45 minutes to an hour every single day. So the main thing is really just nutrition and keeping that on lock. So far, the past 2 months, I've been pretty locked in and I haven't always been very motivated to do so. So I'm really hoping I can just stick that out and not let people, friends or whatever, take me off of my main goal. When I move out, I'm definitely going to try and make some friends who have the same fitness interests. My friends there are big into surfing, so I'll definitely have a good surf community off the bat. But really need to stay locked in, get my school stuff done, get to work. And I've been working a whole bunch recently, like 3-4 times a week. And really just trying to crank it out, put all my money into savings. Been using Acorns and just been like spamming all my money into that. I have automatic like adding into it. And my dad's been setting me up with that for like a few years. So now that I've received the account, I'm really just trying to keep that on like a consistent thing I do. Because my main goal with that is to use it as my first down payment for my first property. So there's a bunch of stuff going on. I'm going to try and keep this as like a timestamp more so than trying to get famous or anything. This isn't really that's not really my goal. But I mean, obviously, it's a part of it. To try and make this what I do, that'd be amazing. I mean, that's really my life recently. I haven't been doing anything too crazy. Been doing a couple backpacking trips and just trying to meet new people and see new things and just take everything in while I'm young. My dad, when he was my age, he was in the Israeli army, so I'm trying to really just follow in that kind of footsteps and make sure I'm not just wasting my life, especially when I'm older. I want to be looking back and being like, oh, I'm so glad I did this. Like, or I wish I didn't do this. Like, I'd rather say I wish I didn't do it than saying, what if I did this? My biggest fear really is, like, I mean, honestly, kind of just scares me, is, say, I'm not, like, religious, but if there is an afterlife or something, if I'm, like, told this is who I could have been, and I wasn't even close to it, that just, like, scares me to where I want to be the best person that I can be. And I feel like this past year I've learned a lot about myself and what I want to do with my life. But obviously I'm still pretty young and I'm still trying to figure everything out. It's definitely been a very strange year for me. My friend group's kind of been all over. I've just been kind of bouncing around a bunch of people, and I feel like I still have a pretty stable, like, few. Obviously Jacob and those, that same group that I've used to post videos with, are like number one. And my sister's like super supportive, parents are super supportive. I'm just trying to figure out everything that's going on, because it's kind of kicking in now that I'm gonna be moving to the opposite side of the country. And it's scary. I mean, you can't deny it. It's certainly there, to where I'm gonna be living alone thousands of miles away from really anybody I know. And it's just breaking through that mentality of, oh, I need to rely on people to do what I can do. And it'll really open a new door if I can stick to the same discipline while I move. And it'll really test just everything about what I do. I mean, that's basically it. Thank you guys for watching this video. I'm gonna keep the consistency there. And take care.